Hello, Dr. Dilip Gude here, physician and diabetologist, Yashoda Hospitals, Somajiguda. Let us discuss about diabetes treatment and the latest options that we have. In fact, in the last 7-8 years, if you see, there are fantastic advancements, fantastic guidelines that have been developed, that have been recommended by international bodies like ADA, that is American Diabetic Association, even European Union, and many other such, in fact, our own RSSDI as well. So there is more emphasis on use of SGLT2 inhibitors. So these are nothing but a class of medicines that help enable the kidneys to excrete the extra sugar in the body into urine. So this way, apart from lowering sugar and getting fantastic sugar control, we're also going to get fantastic benefits in the form of decreased incidence of heart attacks, decreased kidney disease progression from diabetes, decreased heart failure incidences, and apart from also lowering blood pressure and body weight, that is decrease in body fat content. So these molecules are so important that in fact after metformin they need to be used as a must, unless otherwise contraindicated. Now, when do you not use these classes? When people have increased genital mycotic infections, that is fungal infections or bacterial infections, urinary tract infections recurrently. So in these classes, we don't use, but in every other diabetic patient, this class of medicines, that is empagliflozin, dapagliflozin, and carnagliflozin must be used because the benefits are enormous and you can't deprive of a diabetic patient by not giving this class of medicine. So it is important to have a conversation with your doctor and ask for this particular class of medicines in diabetes treatment. Now coming to another class of medicine, diabetic treatment, that is GLP-1 receptor agonists. Now these are dulaglutide, liraglutide, and oral semaglutide. This class of medicines are also fantastic in the sense that they have minimized heart disease, then cholesterol plaque deposition in the arteries, then minimized kidney disease progression from diabetes, and apart from also controlling sugars and bringing down body fat and overall body weight. So it is really important to have a conversation with your physician or diabetologist or cardiologist and discuss if you are on this class of medicines or not. Because if not, you might be getting deprived of these enormous, great benefits of lowering your cardiovascular risk and lowering your nephrotoxic risk or kidney disease progression from diabetes. So it is really important that you minimize the use of sulfonylureas. Now this is the class that is most commonly used in India, that is rampantly used. In fact, probably 80% of Indian diabetic patients are on this class, that is glimepiride, gliburide, glipizide, glycolazide. So this class of medicines are going to, this class pushes the pancreatic beta cells to secrete more and more insulin, and over a period of say 4 to 5 years or even 7 years or so, pancreas has no more insulin to secrete, and this is called beta cell exhaustion. So sulfonylureas usually push pancreatic beta cells to the brink of exhaustion, which is why the use of sulfonylureas needs to be minimized or actually stopped whenever possible. Likewise, the use of insulin is also not commonly advocated, or it might actually be discouraged, because there are some classes of medicines where when you use those classes, the amount of insulin required per day comes down drastically to 70% comes down drastically by 70% or more, meaning somebody on say 70 units of insulin per day, you can bring it down to probably 20 units of insulin per day, or probably you can even stop them of insulin. So this helps patients get fantastic sugar control, lower their risk of hypoglycemia, that is sugars falling, and get enormous benefits of protecting their heart and kidney, then getting their blood pressure controlled, bringing their overall body fat content down, apart from lowering blood sugars to the normal level. Thank you.